Welcome to this video on how to submit a ruling request in the CARM Client Portal. In this video, you will learn how to complete basic information needed for all ruling requests, how to complete specific details needed for tariff classification rulings, and how to add supporting information. Let us begin. On the homepage, make sure you are in the correct account. Change accounts if you are not. To go to the Rulings page, either click on the Rulings link found here, or select Rulings from the drop-down menu. Click Rulings again to continue. There are two steps in every ruling request: entering the ruling context and entering the ruling details. First, let's review the ruling context. This standard information is required for all ruling requests, regardless of type. Click the Request a New Ruling button. Select the type of ruling you want to request from the drop-down menu. There are a number of different types you can select from, including tariff classification, origin, and valuation rulings. For this video, we chose a tariff classification ruling, the most common type of request. Select the port of entry through which the goods will be imported into Canada. You can search by typing part of the port's name or by using the port code. You will be asked if the goods have ever been the subject of a ruling, a review, or an appeal before. Click the appropriate answer or none of the above. Answer whether or not the goods have been imported into Canada before. If you click yes, you will need to answer whether or not they will continue to be imported into Canada. For this example, we will select no. Indicate whether or not you would like the CBSA to make your ruling publicly available. Click yes or no. If you click yes, the CBSA will post your ruling to the CARM site for the benefit of the importing community. At this point, you may save your request as a draft. Input the desired name and click Save Draft. You can find your drafts in the list of rulings on the Rulings page. You can continue to work on a saved draft by clicking the pencil icon to edit. After completing this page, click Next to continue. Now, let's review the ruling details. This is the second part of a ruling request, in which detailed information specific to the type of selected ruling will be entered. As a reminder, this video specifically shows the details for a tariff classification ruling. We chose a tariff classification because it is the most common type of ruling request. Input detailed information about the goods, including their description, specifications, and manufacturer. Input a list of materials, ingredients, and the composition of the goods in as much detail as possible. Write a description of how the goods are made. Enter the applicable tariff classification number. Enter the reason why it is believed that tariff classification applies to these goods. Are you applying for conditional relief? Click yes or no. If yes, enter the number for the conditional relief tariff item. Type the intended use of the good. Type a description of how the goods will be packaged. It is easier and faster for the CBSA to render a decision on a ruling when supporting documents and information are included. Check this box if you do not have proprietary information or if the information is forthcoming from the manufacturer. You may also link to information or documents hosted on the manufacturer's website. Enter the URL or website link here. Just like the ruling context section, you can either save your draft here or click Previous to go back. Click the Submit and Add Attachments button to submit your request. A confirmation of the ruling request will be displayed and a case number will be generated. This ruling will now appear in your list of rulings with the status Submitted. Click the Add Attachments button. To upload a file, click here or drag and drop a file to this space to attach it to your ruling request. Accepted file formats are displayed here. Specify the document type in the drop-down menu. Click the Upload button to complete the uploading process. If you would like to view the details of your submission, click the View Confirmation button. If you have additional documents to include, click the Upload a Document link to repeat the process. Or click here to return to the Rulings Request page. Here are some key points to remember. There are several types of ruling requests, tariff classification being the most common one. Ensure you include as much information as possible regarding the ruling context and details. And finally, attach supporting documents when possible. Thank you for watching.